are making pencil toppers. These are fun and easy to make. They're made out of paper, can you believe it? Paper and flour. And they're really cute and quirky, I think. Now, I'm going to show you how to make the teddy bear today, but if you want to have a look at any of the other designs, keep watching, and at the end of the video, you can take a closer look at each one. I think this one's particularly fun. Come on then, let's see how these little guys are made. So, to make your lovely pencil holders made from paper, I mean, it is amazing. You will need some pencils, that's to give you shape for your pencil holder, and you will need some of this DIY paper mache paste. Now this is literally made from paper, water and flour. If you look up here and down below, I show you how to make it. It's really easy, it's super fun. You can make it from shredded paper or you can make it from newspaper. So it's up to you, but this is actually made from shredded paper. And then all you do is you take a little lump out. Let's see if this is a good amount. You don't want it too big actually. You actually don't need very much. This is a really thrifty, cute craft. Great for you know, making with lots of people. If you want to make lots of these as presents, you can make a whole set. And then you just make sure it's nicely and smooth so that there's no sort of cracks appearing. And then you gently just squish it around your pencil. And then just shape it. Make sure all the cracks are shut. Give it a little shape. Whatever shape you want. I just think this sort of basic shape is really easy to do. You can mold it a bit more. I've experimented and done lots of different shapes, but this really is the easiest. And this is perfect for a little monster. So like this one, isn't it cute? But you might want to, for example, make a little tiger or a little teddy bear. So what you do next is you then carefully, once you've got your basic shape right, get a little bit more out. And just shape some ears. I'm going to do some cat ears for this one, but I might, you know, I've got quite a few to show you in terms of painting, so I'm going to shape it into a little triangle and then find your front, and I'm going to just gently squeeze it on. So if your dough is sticky enough, or you've put enough flour in, this really gently does actually just glue on, but you do have to kind of smooth it down a bit too, just to make sure it stays. Then I'm going to make a second ear. Another little triangle and pop it on this side. And that's your basic cat or tiger shape. Now that's all I did for these ones. I've put nothing on the back, I've just kept it really simple. But of course at this point, if you want to start experimenting and add like a little tail or something, you can. But I would, for the first few, just keep it as simple as possible. Then put it on some Tupperware and let it dry, or on a tray or something, and it will probably take 2 or 3 days to dry. I sometimes give it a little turn. Now whilst it's drying, do keep your pencil inside, because the paper will contract and get smaller, and if you don't leave the pencil inside, it won't fit back in afterwards. So it does, you know, it's quite a little bit stiff, and you can, once it's drying, give it a little wiggle just to make sure it holds its shape on the inside, but very gently. This one's held it really well. And also if you want, you can actually glue them onto the pencil. I quite like being able to take them off. And also you can paint the pencils later to match your design. But do keep the pencil on, because that means you'll have the right sized hole. So anyway, we're going to let this dry and then we're going to come back and we're going to paint one of these little pencil toppers. Come on then, let's wait for the next step. Okay, I think you can hear the rain. It's very rainy here. Now this one's dried. Now make sure that obviously that your pencil still fits in. You don't want to finish your teddy bear and then it doesn't stay on your pencil. So do make sure it fits nicely. And then it's time to paint. Now I'm using something called enamel gloss. You can also use acrylic paints. You can probably use poster paints, but with both the acrylic and poster paints, you would then put a varnish on it just to give it that final finishing touch. I'm also going to use one of these pens for details, but you can use a Sharpie or a marker pen. It's literally use the materials you have in your home. And just go from there. So I'm going to make a purple teddy bear. And I'm just literally going to just squeeze on some of this lovely purple enamel paint. And cover it in blue and let it dry. Now the handy thing is, because it's a pencil topper, I can put up my pencil and I can just paint it. And these enamels really are so lovely, but I understand that not everyone has this, so really do have a look at the paints you've got at home. You could probably just color them in with Sharpies, although that's a little bit trickier because the surface is a bit bumpy. But just experiment what you've got and see how well it works. Now this needs to dry, and all I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of my tins, this one's a plain one, pop it in, and we can let it dry and then come back for the next layer. So here he is again, the little bird. Isn't he adorable? So cute. I think they're super fun, and I love how thrifty this craft is. Now remember, I'm just going to walk you through all the other little designs, and you can choose which one you would like to make. Anyway, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, but above all, keep watching, keep making, keep creating, and of course, we'd love to see you again soon. Take care. Bye.